Teddy Rumpskin here, and you know, Star Wars: The Force Awakens is opening very fucking soon. But I just wanted to throw out this fucking theory about the movie before it opened, you know, just because. Wait, and my theory is that Luke Skywalker is the villain, you know. I mean, yeah. Spoiler alert, in case it's fucking true. Well, I mean, it might not be, but I think fucking Luke Skywalker's the villain in the fucking Star Wars The Force Awakens. That's what I think's going on. You know, that's why we haven't really seen him in the fucking trailers yet. Because he's a villain. And maybe he looks a little scary or something, right? I mean, I have good reason to think this, okay? Because I saw this video from like a long time ago, like 10 years ago. This show called Dinner for Five. It had fucking Stan Lee, Jason Lee, Kevin Smith, and J.J. Abrams and Mark Hamill all having dinner together, talking about, you know, Hollywood and shit, right?
Young woman who I knew, Jill Mazursky, who's Paul Mazursky's daughter, mm-hmm. And she had sold some stuff.
This is probably, like, one of the first times that Mark Hamill ever fucking met J.J. Abrams. You know what I'm saying?
Wow. My first thing, which is, you know, impossible. But I kept feeling like...
Yeah. And now they're working together on the Star Wars The Force Awakens. And during the dinner, Mark Hamill mentioned how he wanted to play a villain in Return of the Jedi.
No, as an actor, that would be more fun to play. I just thought that's the way it was going. From when we finished 2, I figured that's what will be the pivotal moment. I'll have to come back, but it'll be like I'll have Han Solo in my crosshairs, and I'll be about to kill him, or about to kill the princess, or about to kill somebody that we care about. And, you know, it'll be, it's an old cornball movie.
Yeah, I mean, that's why it would be an interesting thing to happen in the fucking new Star Wars movie, you know? Turns out Luke Skywalker's a bad guy. He's the fucking villain behind Kylo Ren, right? Or something. You know, what fucking more better than fucking Jar Jar fucking Binks being the fucking bad guy? That's such a stupid theory, but yeah. What about Luke Skywalker, right? He's a fucking villain, you know? And I mean, there's another clip I got from even further back in 1977, where him and Harrison Ford and Carrie Fisher were appearing on a talk show talking about the movie.
I mean, we thought it was going to be a good picture, or we wouldn't have been there, but we had no idea it was going to take off the way it had.
I've never talked to him.
And the host of the show mentions that Mark Hamill was well known for fucking playing bad guys on television, right? Yes.
But always on TV, you're always cast as a bad guy, right?
Yes.
What is it about you that they...
Wow, so Mark Hamill played villains on fucking television? What, he played like bad guys on cop shows and shit? Or he played like a junkie or something?
I just got on a roll. I started getting junkies and snipers and killers and murderers and...
Guess he plays a junkie. That's good. Yeah, I can imagine Mark Hamill playing a pretty good junkie. Right? Sure, why not? Yeah. But another role that Mark Hamill's really well known for is a villain. He's the voice of the Joker on the Batman cartoon show. And in the Batman video games. In fact, a lot of people think that Mark Hamill is probably, like, the best Joker ever, right? Although, it is a lot of competition for that fucking title. I mean, I love Jack Nicholson as the Joker, right? And Heath Ledger's performance as the Joker is fucking phenomenal. But lots of people like Mark Hamill's performance as the Joker. He's come back and done it numerous fucking times, you know what I'm saying? I mean, because really Mark Hamill's good at playing villains, apparently, you know what I mean? And he likes playing villains. And I mean, look at him here. This is like 10 years ago here, where he's at dinner with fucking Kevin Smith. And later he would play a villain in a Kevin Smith movie. Yeah, he played the Cockknocker in Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back, right? Yeah. And, just look at him. This is him 10 years ago. See his posture, the way he's leaning forward and stuff like that? I mean, look at him more recently. He did something for Star Wars where he's, like, dressed up like a stormtrooper. And, you know? I mean, he just doesn't seem... I don't know. I just can't see him not being the fucking bad guy. You know what I'm saying? It just makes sense. I almost can't see him coming back as a heroic character. You know, it almost makes more sense for him to turn to the dark side, like his father before him, you know what I mean? But, I don't know. It's just a fucking theory, and I just wanted to throw it out there before the fucking movie actually comes out, you know? Yeah. But, anyway, Till fucking next time, keep it fucking real.
But, you know, I'm good about keeping secrets. I'm proud of the fact that I knew a year and a half before anybody else that he was actually Dad Vader. I didn't even tell Harrison, you know, so...